Sit with me, Outlander. I've got something to tell you. A few days ago, I came across a massive bloom of flowers east of the grove. Old Dorica was out there, too. I offered to escort her back to Scalding Spear, but she refused. She's an accomplished soldier, to be sure. But her spear isn't as sharp as it used to be, if you get my meaning.
If I'm out there, I'll keep an eye out for her.
Take a look or move on.
Fight.
that. Is it enough?
Stuff.
have something to say, champion. Be careful if you're traveling southwest, champion. Rebels have set up camp in the hills. I'm sure they'd be more than happy to dig your grave.
Thanks for the warning. Sounds like the Tanath could use a hand dealing with these rebels.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade. Next time, right?
Snowfall's blanketing the land.
You look geared up for battle. Always a smart choice.
An honor, champion. I'm Nako. Have you been out to the Valley of the Fallen, by chance?
Don't think I have. Why? What's there?
My idiot little brother. The Valley is a test of endurance and skill for my clan, the Lowlanders. But it's been closed for months. Commander's orders. There have been reports of strange lights off the coast, and the whole area is crawling with deadly machines. But Dax, reckless and bare-armed as he is when in any way, never takes no for an answer. Convinced two others to go with him, too. They've been missing for days, and now Marshal Ivir has been sent in to bail them out.
Strange lights, deadly machines, and missing soldiers? Sounds like a lot, even for a marshal.
I'd go by myself, if I wasn't stuck on transport duty.
I'll find your brother, if I can. Where is this valley?
Southwest of here. In the depths of Lowland territory. Look for the climbing path on the cliffs. It marks the start of the valley. And if you see my brother, knock him on his ass for making me worry.
Strange lights off the coast. Whatever it is, it can't be good.
If you've got medals, you're worthy of our gear, champion.
Face off against machines and prove your worth to the clans.
What can I do for you, Aloy?
Oh, sorry. I don't actually have any tags right now.
No problem. Let me know when you find some. Earn more medals and the rewards will be great.
Well, I guess I should go.
Safe travels.
Walk tall, champion of the
court. You fought Regala.
Yep.
And so you're
welcome. Share the same enemy.
Lots of strength.
You've earned your honor. So many marks for that.
What do you mean?
Good to see you.
Come and learn about life as a soldier.
It's Aloy.
Moments later, the entire grove was filled with lights.
Like the days of the first Tanakh.
Even more. The truth of the visions was revealed to us. Then, we gathered here and listened to Faraday's words.
And this was the same message Chief Hikaru saw.
Oh, yes. Unity against our common struggles. Peace instead of war.
I wish I could have seen it.
Aloy, I was just telling Kavo how you revealed the visions after Regala's attack on the Kulrut.
I've always wondered what Chief Hikaru saw and heard the day he conquered the grove. Now we know.
I'm sorry you don't get to see it too.
It's okay. I know a chaplain who was there.
The deeds of the Ten have always inspired us in battle. Now they will guide us towards peace as well. All thanks to you, Aloy.
Better not steal any more of these recordings.
Can I ask you something?
Of course.
I've brought you more of the voices you're collecting.
Another chance to learn about this lost war. We will honor the voices here.
I'll see if this...
Are you almost done?
I was annoyingly impatient at your age, too.
Everything okay? What are you doing out here?
Ask my grandmother. I risked leaving guard duty to look for her. She stopped to see the bloom, and now she won't leave. Since when does she care about flowers?
They're not just flowers, child. They're scarlet stems with a scent that soothes the nerves. Or so I was told many years ago by an Utaru seed tracker.
An Utaru? Now you're telling stories. If one trespassed here back then, you'd have killed him on sight.
I couldn't. Found him picking flowers, right near here, in Tanakh territory. I was all set to strike him down, but he was singing.
Singing?
Can't remember the tune now. Just the lilt of his voice. And his name. Nilo. He decided to stay for a day or two. I took guard duty here so I could keep coming back to him. And he kept delaying his return to Plainsong. For the flowers, he said.
Please don't tell me I'm descended from an Utaru gardener.
Almost. Almost. But the thrill of battle called to me, and he had to return to his people. I've always wondered about the life I missed with him. whether he misses it too. Would he welcome me in plain song? Or at least accept a scarlet stem?
It's a long way to plain song, but I get back there now and then. I could pick some scarlet stems and bring them to Nilo, if I can find him.
Please. He was an herbalist there. I know the time has long since passed, but I'd like to know. Well, I'd like him to know. You know what I mean.
I think I do.
Encouraging an old woman? Why would you do that?
Why wouldn't I?
Think she'll find that Nilo guy?
I thought you didn't care.
I don't. Not really.
You want to take a moment and admire the view?
Okay. And?
I'm done. I can't believe I chased you all the way out here for this!
And I can't believe how much you complained about it.
I should look for the herbalist. Might still be Nilo. I could give him the scarlet stems.
Good hunting, Outlander. May you always walk. Hunting up! Let's trade! Are you alright, dear?
How many?
Careful, Outlander. These fields are wrought with life.
Outlander, what can I do for you?
You're the herbalist here, right? Are you Nilo?
No, Nilo was before my time. I think he went up north a while back to Riverhim. Why? Do you need a special salve?
No, but someone else does, in a way. Thanks. I'll try Riverhim.
There's a grove there, a memorial, a beautiful greenery. If he's there, I bet he'll be tending it.
Thanks again.
Glad I could help. I hope you find what you're looking for in Riverhim.
Stranger, be on the lookout for poisonous plants. Slight.
Lao and Ven. Reunited after the war.
Feeling better?
Yeah.
My conscience, too.
There she is, the hunter that saved my sorry rump.
I'm glad she did. I shouldn't have left you out there.
Enough of that. If you hadn't run, you'd be dead, and no use to anyone.
He's right. That Clawstrider was a killer.
Thank you, Outlander. You saved us both. I wouldn't have been able to live with the guilt.
What's next, then? A Thunderjaw? A Stormbird?
More like a nap.
Sleep well, then. You deserve it.
You can't send people. Not today. The work has to be done.
Okay, Riverhim. I should look for Nilo. Give him the Scarlet Stems. The herbalist in Plainsong said he might be near the Memorial Grove.
Ada.
How are you?
Nilo.
Did she say Nilo? Hi there.
Nora. Here. You're a long way from home.
I suppose I am. I'm looking for an herbalist named Nilo. I think I heard you say his name.
You've come to the right place. His seeds were buried here, where he tended the blooms of others. Including my mother's. I'm his daughter, Gia.
How long has he been gone?
Some 5 years now. He put a lot of love into this grove. Almost as much as he gave me. That's why I could never abandon Riverhim.
I'd like to leave some flowers, if I may. From an old friend of his.
Scarlet Stems! They're rare in these parts, but they were his favorite. I never knew why. He planted them whenever he could, but never picked them. Preferred to just watch them bloom.
Sounds about right. So he was a good man, who led a full life?
He was. And he did. I don't know who this old friend is, but if my father liked them, they must be a good soul.
Be over quick with that. Stemo. Thank you.
Look, the Outlander's back.
I can still see well enough, girl.
Is my long vigil over? You have word from my grandmother's gardener?
Yes and no. I laid the scarlet stems at his grave. His favorite flower, according to his daughter. Always loved to watch them bloom.
He's gone. But he did think of me over the years. That'll have to be enough.
Really? That's it? Are you sure you got the right herbalist?
Huh. Seemed like you thought it was a fool's errand.
Well, it's just that it meant something to you. It could have been a whole other life.
Could have been. But this life hasn't turned out so bad. Even have a granddaughter who cares enough to come looking for me out in the wilds. And I've still got scarlet stems to remind me of Nilo.
Sounds like your grandmother's got it all figured out.
Maybe she does. Just tell me the next time you want to come out here, okay? Instead of disappearing?
Maybe I will. Here, Outlander. Take this. For helping an old woman to remember she was once young.
Wind's blustering about something. I could prime it with plasma ammo. It could work against that machine.
Thank you.
Pouch is full, but my pack has room. Plasma will make quick work of it. The soldier warned me about them. Whatever they're doing, it can't be good.
Thank you. Another alert.
You!
I found her!
This way! In that patch!
I've been spotted.
Fire! There's still a chance we hit her! You're with me! Take the lead! Death won't come swiftly for you! That outlander. You, on me.
Oh, relief.
Saw her run into the grass. We do not forgive.
You're gonna make me come in.
Whoever's giving the orders around here, I can figure out what they're up to. Soon.
The champion killer. Are you here to wipe out these traitors?
I'm here to help. So just follow
my
lead.
Easy enough.
Like they're getting ready to ship out these weapons and armor. Probably to rebels all over the West. That'll hurt their operations if I get rid of them.
It's that outlander. Has to be.
5 shards say I track her down first.
I'm tired of controls.
Let's see what I can do with this.
She's back. Stay alert. Find that coward!
Why do I always have to follow you? An eye for an eye! These guys are friendly. There. Taking the shot!
I
now.
I'm ready.
Okay. Let's find her. Ready? Then go. Well, what's there?
You could be anywhere.
On the way, you know.
To all sons of Prometheus engineers and operatives, I've been hearing some belly aching, whining about the Tanakh, the work, the conditions, the occasional limb loss to a machine when someone gets careless. I get it. It's been a long road. We've suffered. We'll continue to suffer. But we're close. This alliance will get us what we want, I promise. The Karja will pay for the Red Raids in blood. And so will all of their collaborators in the Vanguard and back in the claim. So shut up. Get back to work and always remember, a reckoning is on the way.
It sounds like the Sons of Prometheus want blood. And the Karja are the target. The Vanguard too. Let's see what else these guys have been up to. Map. It marks supply lines, the different outposts. Rebels have been busy making weapons and armor. So I was right. This place makes weapons and armor and ships them out to their troops. I should destroy as many munitions as possible. That should hurt the rebels' operations. Those weak points. It should bring the bridge down. These in my pack. That should be all of them. Guess the rebels will have to resupply elsewhere.
heard of you.
Your exploits must be correct.
Different from those.
Are you certain there's nothing you require? Okay, new approach.
That Osram camp Talia and I were trying to find should be around here. smoke. Could be from a camp. Maybe I should check it out. That might be the Osirim camp the Tanakh told me about. I should talk to their leader.
Now she's in the wilds, all alone. Forge knows all the things that could kill her out there.
Someone ran off?
Never got her name. Kept quiet. Couldn't tell if she was shy or scared. All I know is she didn't want anyone near her things.
That's for sure. I was just curious, is all. She didn't have to slug me.
Your glass jaw ain't the problem, Lugnut. The girl is. All alone in the bush? And this is Tanakh territory.
Which way did she go?
West, up the slope. Look for her if you can.
I will.
Careful now. Girl's maladjusted.
Did you hear about that traveling Osirim?
Going down. Frostammo could help here.
Thank you.
spotted. Part of the city. Las Vegas, maybe. This doesn't look right. Maybe I should try somewhere higher? The sandstorm's giving its all. Of this image looks a lot like the one I picked up this vista point from. Maybe there's a spot nearby that overlooks it? I think I might be close to where the image was taken. Should be easier to look around now without those machines. What was he doing in the pool? The screenshot might trade for something good. The officer on my map said someone in their crew ran off in this direction. I should keep my eyes open.
Stay back! Get away from my rig!
Sounds like someone's in trouble.
No!
Is it safe? Did they get to it? Please be in charge. Please.
I should make sure she's okay.
Spike is still intact. Rig's still playing.
You okay there?
You took out those machines. I'm grateful, but you should go now. There's nothing to see here.
So this rig of yours, it's receiving sound through that wire from the thing up on the cliff, what you call a spike. But the message is only a fragment, and you're trying to pick up the whole thing?
How did you figure all that out?
I've learned a few things in my travels. If you want, we could talk about it. Maybe I can help?
You do seem downright knowledgeable. So go ahead. Shoot.
You're no ordinary tinker.
Didn't used to be a tinker at all. More of a metal worker. Came from Mainspring. Hagenwald seems so fine, you could barely see it. Not that I ever got any credit for it. You see, up there, you've got to be a man to get ahead. I once had a shot at joining a first-rate crew, one of the best forges in the claim. But I didn't get the job. My own brother wouldn't vouch for me just because I'm of the female persuasion. Anyhow, at least out here I don't have to worry about any Mainspring men talking down to me.
Sounds like you're still mad at your brother.
Some days I am. Other days, I miss him. He's passed on, you see. He didn't have the guts to go against the blast of the bellows and vouch for a lady. Even his own sister. It was cowardly. And I told him so. In fact, I told him we weren't family no more. But over time, I've had cause to regret it. He wasn't a bad sort. He knew how to make me smile when he wasn't being such a lout.
I'm sorry he's gone.
Yeah. So am I. Blast it all.
Your rig's impressive. How does it work?
Well, like you said, the spike up there seems to capture the sound. It travels by wire down to my contraption. I put some coils in there and a light sheet of metal that vibrates, making the sound louder. I'm not exactly sure why it works, but it just does.
And you set it up out here all alone?
I'm not the trusting type. Pretty much everything I do is all alone.
How did you first hear the message?
I used to be a smith up in the claim. Wasn't an easy life. A lot of hard work without much to show for it. Then one day, I heard a whisper coming from a steel rod. Faint. Like the last fingers of steam coming off a cooling forge. When I moved the rod around, the whispers got louder. I did some tinkering, built my rig, and did my best to follow that sound. Further west I came, the stronger it got. Then I found that spike up there. When I hooked up my rig, the words were clearer than ever.
What do you think the message is?
I don't know. There's something sad about it. Feels like it's from one lost soul to another. I'd sure like to know what it means.
Let me have a look at that spike. I might be able to pick up more of that message.
How?
Let's just say I have a rig of my own.
I didn't know Nora were tinkers.
They're not, but I am, in a way. Be right back.
Well, okay then. I guess. Just follow the wire to the spike at the top. And please, just don't break anything.
Climbing. Hot as an Othram forge, as Erend would say. Gotta give her credit, lugging all that wire up a cliff wall. There's a spike. Might get better reception if I'm next to it.
Supply drop beacon. Oh. Pretty good. The note.
Enduring victory. Interesting. Can't seem to get a fix on where the signal's coming from, though. Well, better let the Tinker know I got a bit more of the message. This ought to be a good shortcut. Rig is picking up an old world message. A recording of some kind.
Thought as much. Did you hear more of it?
A bit. It was recorded during a war. A bad one.
Maybe that's why it sounds so darn sad. There's something about it that makes me think of my late brother. May his ashes stay warm in the forge. Not sure why, exactly.
I I still can't get a fix on the source.
Well, the words grew stronger when I got out here.
What if you moved the rig now? Try to see if you can get a stronger signal elsewhere.
Even if I could dodge the Tanakh and the machines, I can't lose that spike. Nothing else pulls down the words better.
Okay. If it's an old world message, then let's try old world methods. They used to pinpoint signals by listening for them at three different spots. The taller, the better. And then they combined the information and used it to find the source.
And you can do that?
I think so. But your spike is only one spot. I need two more, both up high.
Oh. Well, there's a big bright tower in the Tanakh territory north of here.
Yeah, that should work. I have another spot in mind, near a place I'm... camping.
Wait. I don't know your name. Or why you do all of this for someone you just met.
Aloy. And because I want to know what's out there. Same as you.
Silga. And when you find it, Aloy, I'd be eager to hear what it is.
I wish you could talk. That would help a lot.
Gotta climb up to look for Silga's signal. But where to start? Take it from a girl who grew up in the wilds. Birds don't provide much conversation.
That's for sure. How are you doing, Aloy?
Well, better than you, I think. At least I'm not chatting with animals. What's wrong?
Meat here flew in yesterday with this in its beak. It's a cord that the Tanakh children use to carry their training swords. The kind of thing one of our young doesn't lose unless something bad has happened. I checked around. Turns out a kid is missing. Wandered off the day before last. Search parties turned up nothing. Gotta tell you, I'm not in the mood to lose one of my people. Especially a child.
Let me see that thing. There's a bit of quartz on here. It's probably sand, some dirt. And clay, with a red hue.
Sand, dirt, and red clay? I know a spot where all three meet. Just south of the settlement. Will you meet me there and help check it out? Maybe use that relic of yours. The way things have been going, I can't trust this to anyone else.
I'll get there as soon as I can.
I can always count on you.
Sounds like Yara is feeling isolated. climbing to pinpoint that signal. Just a little higher. Almost there. Stuff for the stash. Okay. Let's see if I can pick up Silva's signal. Source yet. Climbing the mountain where my base is should finish the job.
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
You shouldn't miss this chance to trade.
You should know the rebels have been busy. They've set up outposts to the west. And I know the marshals can't deal with all of them, so I'd stay alert out there if I were you.
Thanks for the warning. Getting rid of those outposts might stop the rebels from killing more of their own. Maybe I can lend the marshals a hand.
Thank you.
toward fire.
Doesn't like purge water. Message. Just gotta look for the power.
Black.
I need to get higher up. Find a good spot to pick up Silka's signal.
This is quite a climb. I have to get higher to try and pinpoint Silga's signal. Strong against frost ammo. Looks like I have company. Okay, now to pick up the signal. Where's the best spot? Huh? I should try to find a good spot to pick up Silga's message. Signal's origin. It's not too far from here. I just need to get to it.
Thank you.
There you are. Now, how to get to you? But I'll need to deal with these machines first. Fire against it. Find my way to the signal source. Getting in that way. I should search for another way in. Thank you. I'd take advantage of that. Right, into the water. There you are. Now, what's inside?
Paula, I couldn't raise you via focus. I hope this gets to you somehow. As long as you're for the stand at the Rego line. Just wanted you to know that all the bitterness is water under the bridge. Remember the good things, and I'll think about them when the darkness comes.
Sounds like she really cared about him. Silga will want to know about this, and she'll definitely be interested in the transmitter inside that's been sending the message. Sky. Must be a Cyclops drone. How to get its data? Gotta bring the drone down to grab its data. Maybe if I jump onto it?
Did anybody else see something?
Being a bit paranoid, maybe?
I can get out of this.
Fine. No apologizing for being careful, though. Pull yourself together. Are you all right? Did you see that?
Go, then.
This just happened. And of course, I'm by myself. Taking you with me.
I should grab the drone's data now that it's down. End of another day.
Aloy, the words stopped coming from the spike. What happened?
This is what was speaking to your rig. It's old world equipment used for communicating over long distances. The message must have shut off when I took it, but I heard the note the voice was talking about.
What was it?
During an ancient war, a woman was trying to deliver supplies to a man she knew. She wanted him to know that their past disagreements didn't matter in the big picture. That she'd be thinking of him when the end came.
Oh. I guess she and I are kin of a sort. I wish I could give my brother a message like that. Tell him that I forgave him. He would have wanted that. I know. This man, the old one, did he ever hear the message?
I don't think so.
I guess that's often the way of it then. But still, with the power of that device you found, the sender had hope that he might have heard it. What a feat! To send messages, near and far. Can I keep this? It's a treasure.
Of course.
Thank you. Sometimes, people don't ever get to hear what they should. But with this thing, maybe I can get them talking to one another. From Mainspring, all the way to who knows where.
Hey, I found a few more things in the supply cache. Might be able to make something out of them. Can I use your workbench?
Sure. Yeah, right over there. Anytime, Aloy. It's all yours.
I think I know just what to do with these parts. That turned out well. Can't wait to try it. nearby is sending that signal.
Madam!
Looks like we have company. Kill the point on rest for a moment. Brad should be taller.
Another tall neck. Has to be the one I heard about.
All of us have somewhere better than me.
She cleared out those machines. She's all right by me.
Have I got news for you, Red? One of our scouts found some ancient ruins southwest of here. Had a look for myself, but came out empty-handed. I can't shake the feeling we missed something. Oh well. Must be my disappointment talking.
Maybe you'll have better luck next time. I could always check out the ruins myself. See if there's anything that the Osirim missed. Are you lost?
Spark to steel. Aren't you a jewel in a junk heap?
Excuse me?
Hold the hammer? I know you. You're that Nora. The savior. My savior. Right in the nick of time. The name's Porguff Delvesman, chief delver and leader of Porguff's expeditioners and purveyors of fine delvewares.
What am I saving you from, exactly?
Death and despair, my steel flame friend. See, this grand expedition here has had a minor setback. Not far from here, there's a secret tunnel, a passage of the old ones, lost and then found. Me and half the crew came through first. The other half was supposed to follow right after. But days later, only one man turned up, shivering like a frog in chill water. Only thing we got out of him was that death and darkness chased them as the tunnel collapsed. Died with his eyes wide, he did.
I've been to the tunnel's eastern side. The way was blocked by rubble. There was also a body, one of your delvers, I guess, but no sign of the rest of the crew.
Keep your voice down, will you? The rest of the crew's already spooked. They're refusing to press on with the delve until they're assured a way out of here.
You lost half your crew and you're worried about the delve.
We gotta make their sacrifice worth something, right? And besides, now that you're here, maybe our sand-stranded days are over. Help me get that tunnel reopened, and I'll cut you in on the delver's fee. What do you say?
Was there a Karja traveling with your expedition? A man by the name of Amadis?
We always pick up a few travelers on the road. A Karja here, Banuk there. Never learn their names, though. They don't stick around long. But I have a scout who might know. Likes the whole getting to know people thing. He's right over there. Chatting up that Karja Huntress. Don't remember her joining the Delve either.
Thanks. So this camp, it's your base of operations?
What operations? The plan was to move further south once the rest of the expedition joined us. The Delve is right out beyond those dunes. But now the crew refuses to budge until this tunnel mess gets sorted out. They've even given this place a name. Camp Nowhere. I think they're mocking me.
Yeah. I think they are. How did you learn about this secret tunnel?
The art of the delve, of course. A delve is only as good as his nose sense for good sights. All right, fine. I heard about three Osirim who knew a way to bypass those bloodthirsty Tanakh. Tap the untouched delves of the West. So then I may have employed someone with the know-how for finding and following.
A spy.
Look, if the rumors are true, there's enough delving to employ a dozen operations. But someone has to take the first plunge, establish a base camp, set up a reliable supply route, guard the site against machines.
Figures the Osirim would turn sand into shards, I guess.
Exactly.
What do you know about this area?
Well, north of here you got those vicious Tanakh. I heard rumor they drink blood instead of water. That's how they survive this wasteland. And south, it has it all. Death, desert, and the delve. Imagine, if you will, a vast grave of the old ones. Ruins of twisted metal concealed by the sands. All guarded by machines. So fierce that you'll wish you had a flock of glinthawks swooping down on you instead. Not even the Tanakh venture into the ruins' depths. Only the bravest explorers dare enter.
Like yourself?
Of course. Eventually.
I'll see what I can do about the tunnel.
Ha-ha! My savior.
For the crew trapped here with you, not your Delve.
One and the same.
That it, over there?
That it is. Oh, and while you're at it, would you mind keeping an eye out for my lockbox? The second crew was supposed to bring the rest of the supplies and belongings. I'd hate to lose it to the wilds. It was hand-carved by my dear old Ma.
I'll bring it back, if I find it.
I'd appreciate it. Good luck, Steel Flame.
Dunes might look peaceful, but they hide all kinds of dangers.
Should try something other than fun.
Tanakh outpost nearby.
Ah,
the rebel
line. Oh, I can use your insight.
I have to eat boar stew one more time.
Tanakh built an outpost near you on that one. Shock.
Talana, glad to see you made it.
Thanks to the secret passage through your base. It was quite a sight.
Secret passage? Don't let the others hear you say that, or you'll have a lot of Oseram knocking at your door.
And you are?
This is Raggard. He's a scout with this caravan. He says Amadis was here.
He joined up with our expedition right before we went through the tunnel. After we made camp here, I set out to do some scouting. I also made peace offerings to the Tanakh for trespassing in their territory. Amadis wanted me to ask around about some place called the Rot.
What did you find out?
Most I learned was that it's where the Tanakh took their prisoners. Somewhere far to the west near Thornmarsh, the Lowland Clan's capital. He set out to find it not long after.
On his own?
I tried to warn him, but he was dead set on going.
What happened when you went through the tunnel?
Nothing. Our crew split into two groups to pass through. Everyone here was part of the first crossing. Aside from some pitch-black passages, it was quiet. Whatever befell the second group spared us. Steel Spark be praised.
I'm looking into it.
Much appreciated. A lot of us want to know what happened in there.
Did Amadis say anything about why he was heading to the Rot?
Afraid not. He was a man of few words.
Sounds like him. Did he look okay to you?
More or less. He seemed shaken when we learned the tunnel had collapsed behind us. But then again, so was everyone around here.
So you're a scout for this crew. Anything I should know about the area?
Where to start? Down south, we've got a trio of Oseram trying to delve into the ruins in the sand.
There are more of you?
They're the ones we followed out here in the first place. And then there are all the other folk who broke away as soon as we got to this side of the tunnel. Salvagers, explorers, all sorts of daring venturers.
Just how many of you were there?
Enough to lose track, that's for sure. I've also spotted some rebels a while back, too. Seems like they've been patrolling the desert. Heard all about the rebellion from the Tanakh up in Scalding Spear. That's the Desert Clan's capital, north of here.
Sounds like you've really gotten to know the area.
It's what I do.
Thanks, Ragert. This has been helpful.
Hope you find him.
Okay, I'll head for Thormarsh. Meet me there.
Hold on.
What?
You're willing to go to the ends of Tanakh's territory to find this guy. No hesitation.
Of course, he's one man alone in the Forbidden West. I'm just worried about him.
I think it's more than that. I'll meet you near the Lowland capital. But then, you're going to tell me who Amadis really is.
Fine. I'll lay low, north of the village. See you there.
Wouldn't mind all this getting around if I had a cold.
Some Tanakh built an outpost. Shot me.
There's gotta be another.
Desert was supposed to be.
Maybe if we go up and over.
You can ride machines, right?
Can't go north.
Apparently, you're not the only one.
You!
But you probably.
I know you see me. Like, take it easy today, okay?
Hey, I found the woman who ran off. She's okay. Good to hear.
Hey, I just hope she refrains from fisticuffs in the future.
Please, try. Around here, Red. You're shot. It's a knocker.
Happy hunting to you, Red.
There's the entrance to the tunnel Porgov mentioned. I need to find his missing expedition and clear a path back east. Tunnel's blocked. And no sign of the missing expedition. I need to find a way to get further in. Should be able to blow up that fire gleam. There's someone still alive in here.
You're real. Thought I was dreaming.
What happened to you?
A terror in the dark. The world shuddered.
A machine?
Never got a look. The caravan. We all ran. Everything collapsed. Crawled here. Did anyone make it out? And find the first caravan?
Yes. Someone did.
Good. At least, I'm not alone.
Rest easy now. Sounds like something big attacked the missing expedition. I better press on. sound of that. Missing expedition. Something other than fire. Room. She said they were attacked by some kind of terror. I don't think it was these burrowers. Thank you. stash this away for later. Focus might find something I missed.
Out of here quick. It looks like it lets out ahead.
Time to pull out shock ammo. A rock breaker. It must have attacked the Osirim as they were passing through. lockbreaker that won't be troubling anyone anymore. The Osara must have entered the canyon on the eastern side. I better take a look. For when I need it. Those carts must be the supplies the second crew was supposed to bring over. Borgif said his lockbox was supposed to be among them. Borgif's lockbox. I should take it back to him.
Thank you.
get rid of the vines. More of those strange vines. That wall looks like it came down when the rockbreaker attacked. They must have trapped the Osirim in the canyon. The rest must have run into the western tunnel. Let me get to the other side. I should be able to blow this up to clear the debris. Hitting those blaze barrels with fire ammo should do the trick. The tunnel should be clear now. I better let Portiff know. Got it. of Osram supplies. A dead end. I'm back in no man's land. Now it'll be easier to go back and forth.
Let's see. So, if we add all the days lost to being stuck in Camp Nowhere, and throw in some hazard pay, because no doubt the crew will demand it, but reduce the number of the crew by half. Oh, and can't forget the Savior's Delving fee. Huh. Might just break even. And once the Delve's up and running, the shards will come pouring in.
This was a bad idea.
You're back! How's that tunnel looking?
I found the rest of your crew. One of them was still alive. For a while, anyway. Turns out a rockbreaker attacked them as they were making their way through.
Poor Saz. Many roads lead to Adelva's end, but that's got to be one of the worst.
Well, I took care of the rockbreaker. The way's clear now.
Ha ha! I knew you could do it! And, you didn't happen to find my lockbox now, did you?
Here you go.
Spark in the dark! Is there nothing you can't do? Here, your fee as promised. Now that the threat's gone, I'll have the tunnel shored up and cleared out. Then I can send for another crew, get this expedition going proper-like. Ha! Onwards to the Delve!
I noticed some team riders earlier. They seemed like they were racing or something. I don't know.
You might want to avoid going too deep into the desert, especially the southwest. One of our scouts ran into some nasty Tanakh down there, the kind that contain machines. He barely made it back alive.
Thanks for letting me know. Sounds like the rebels are as friendly as ever. I wonder what they're doing this far out in the desert.
Almost ready to go!